Hey there, thanks for joining me again. Today we're going to carry on with the Magic Frequency series of videos, and we're going to be taking a look at pianos and keys in general, to be honest. So without further ado, let's jump straight into it and crack on, shall we? Alright, so today we're working with the song Is It Any Wonder by Rosellas. Now, as you can see, this is quite a thick session. There's a lot going on in here, which makes it pretty difficult to get anything to really stand out. However, here's what we've got with the piano so far. Alright, so straight off the bat, we want to be looking at around about 5 to 6k to add a little bit of brightness, a bit of sparkle, something along them lines. So let's have a look and a listen. That's quite a dark sounding piano. Don't be afraid to whack that sucker up if you have to. Ultimately, when I first started out, I was a bit afraid of boosting things massively. But I've come to realise that there is no right or wrong. There's just whatever sounds good. So be not afraid of making huge boosts if you really have to. As you can see, I had to go nearly 15 dB on that bad boy. Alright, so next we're going to be looking at somewhere between 1 and 2k, roughly, if we start in the middle and go 1.5. Let's have a look. As you can hear, that kind of helps it to mesh with the guitars a little bit better, because it does sit in a few of the similar frequency ranges as guitars, so just helps it pop out the mix a little bit more. Alright, so next we're going to be looking at the low end and taking care of the low end. Usually I'd be looking maybe somewhere between 100 to 200 maybe as a low end boost, but in the case of this piano I think we're going to need a cut. So let's have a listen and see where we go. Or a boost. Now, for the fourth frequency, sometimes you would need this, oftentimes you wouldn't, but judge by ear. If the piano's a bit woofy, I might look in the sort of 300 to 500 area and see how much mud is going on there, quite broad. Maybe make a cut. Let's have a listen.
Did you ever take?
Now let's bring in a little bit of the channel compression, because it's quite a dynamic performance. Let's just see if we can't smooth it out a little bit. Here we go. Let's get the ratio up a little bit, maybe 2:3:1. That's better. Just pulled the release up a little bit, so it just kind of holds them sustained notes slightly. Let's recap on what we've done. If we bypass this whole plugin, and then we bring it back in, as you can hear, without the EQ, that piano just disappears in the mix, and it's already quite loud. I mean, you'd have to really push it to get it to have its own space. But with these EQ moves, sits really nicely, and it's audible in there, even though you can hear what everything else is doing, which is the whole point, right? So there we have it, guys. That's four magic frequencies that take care of your keys. Thanks a lot for joining me today. And if you haven't seen the rest of the series, please feel free to click on one of the little boxes at the end and watch the rest of the series. You might find something helpful in there. Something might help you out, give you some ideas. I hope so. For those of you that are new to the channel, thanks for joining me. And if you consider subscribing, then that would be excellent. Anyway, thanks a lot for watching today. And until we meet again, be well.